Abu Mustafa fled Mosul during the siege to retake Iraq's second biggest city out of the hands of ISIL, which occupied it 3 years before being exposed. During the insurgents' reign, Mosul's diverse population fell from 2.5 million to 1.5 million. It will take at least another 5 years and many billions of US dollars to clean up all the explosives and repair the city.
They used to work in photography before ISIL took control of Mosul, after which photography stopped. But we kept these cameras. I sold items in the house one by one. The achievement of a lifetime, all of it was gone. These cameras were the last things, but I couldn't make myself sell them. And my wife would not let me sell them either. She said, keep them. Maybe one day things will be back to normal and you can start anew with them until you can afford a better camera. We left our village south of Mosul and walked for 2 or 3 kilometers to a valley called Al Wadi because we were afraid of clashes and bullets in the area. We fled on 26 November 2017, a date I will never forget. Before then, we expected that we would have to leave, so we had made preparations. When we left our home, we took the items that were dearest to us, the cameras and the photo album. My wife put these in the car first, under the driver's seat, so that we would not forget them. The cameras are here now. When we first arrived at the camp, we were in a critical financial situation, so I thought of selling the photography camera. The camcorder I would never sell because I had used it to record the stages of my children's lives, to keep them as memories for them. The camcorder was very precious to us. I sold my wife's gold earrings and kept the camera. She did not accept the idea of selling the camera. The camera had served us and therefore was precious to us. I used this camera for the first wedding party and it paid off. People liked the result. After displacement, when I received this camera that I used to work with IOM, I was a bit hesitant because I was out of practice after 2 difficult years. But step by step, I managed to get the hang of it again, thank God. Now I'm thinking of buying a new camera for myself and use it at home.